Here I am welcoming all for this webinar session. Hope everyone is doing well. Before going ahead, just I introduce myself. Myself Kiran Desai, and I am working as a product specialist in a scope. Okay, so today's topic is primary current injection testing and ideal kit selection criteria. How to select a correct primary current injection test kit. And after that, we will see the primary current test set, the testing equipments like Prima series and second one, Raytom 30K. Before going ahead, if during the presentation, if you are having any queries, you can put in the chat session, and after the presentation, we will have a separate short question and answer session, and in that session we will cover all the questions. Okay, so today's webinar agenda is to understand the basics of primary current injection test. Then we will understand the difference between primary injection and secondary injection. Then applications and importance of primary current injection test, and different IEC guidelines proposed by IEC 61869 for the CT, for the monitoring protection, special protection like that. Then after, how to select a correct primary injection test kit for the high voltage substations. And after that, we will see the key specifications for the primary current injection test kit. And after that, we will see the Prima series, that is the primary current injection test set, and second, the primary current injection test set for high current injection testing. This is the Raytom 30K. Okay, we will move ahead. So the first question arises in our mind: what is the primary current injection test? Why we are saying it is a primary current injection test, and what are the applications of that? So basically, the primary current injection test, this is very helpful, or we can say it is useful for the high voltage and high current substations for testing of current transformer, circuit breakers, or checking the healthiness of relays or circuit breakers, we can say, in the equipments, also in the larger industrial installations. So these are the basic functions that primary current injection test is. It is useful for the high voltage and high current substations or in a larger industrial installations. The basic here is that just we need to flowing a rated current in the circuit that we need to test to ensure or to check the overall healthiness of the equipment and to check the performance of the protection scheme. Here you can see this image on the left side. This is the primary testing equipment that we need to connect directly to the primary side of the equipment, or we can see if it is a CT, we can directly connect it to the primary side of the CT, that is the P1 and P2, and we need to inject that amount of current, that is the rated current, from the primary side of the CT, and after that we can check the secondary current from the secondary side of the CT to ensure the healthiness, that is, of the CT. Similarly for the circuit breakers and relays as well. So this is the direct method to check the healthiness of overall healthiness of the current transformers and circuit breakers. Okay. So then the difference between the primary and secondary current injection test set, the primary current injection, that we need to directly inject a rated current from the primary side of the current transformer, and accordingly we will see how much current is flowing from the secondary side. Basically the CTs are tested, CTs are designed 1 ampere or 5 ampere secondary current. So after injection of the primary current, that is the rated current, we need to check the current is flowing from the secondary side, it is 1 ampere or 5 ampere only. Okay, so this is the direct method to check the healthiness, or we can say to check the behavior of the primary and secondary current. Okay, and secondary injection means whatever parameters we are checking or whatever injection is doing is from the secondary side of the current transformer. That is, here you can see this is our CT core, and this is the utility line, that is the P1 and P2, that we need to connect to the here in secondary side, we need to inject. So in the secondary side, we need to inject a small amount of current or voltage and excitation current or ratio as well. But for checking the ratio, we need to inject the voltage, some voltage from the secondary side, and accordingly we will check the whatever voltage from the primary side. But this is not a direct method that to calculate the ratio of the CT. So this is the indirect method, that is the secondary current injection, secondary injection test. And primary injection, this is a direct method to check the behavior of the CT, that is the ratio, that is the primary current relationship with respect to secondary current. Okay. Then next part is that the applications of the primary current injection test set testing. The first application is the CT testing. So with the help of primary current injection test, we can test CT. It is to determine the relationship between primary current and secondary current seen by the relay is correct or not. Okay, so this is the main application. Then second, CB testing. As I said earlier, that we can directly inject a rated current from the circuit breaker, and we can directly check the CB behavior beyond the set limit or beyond the rated current. Circuit breaker is tripping or not. So with the help of primary current injection test set, we can check. Similarly, protection scheme or relay testing, we can do with the help of primary injection test. As rated current is flowing from the CT, and accordingly with the help of secondary, whenever the limit reach beyond the limit current reaches, then relay will sense and relay will give the command to the circuit breaker. So healthiness or correctness of the protection relay is also very important. So with the help of this primary current injection test, we can easily check. Then other applications to verify the design of GIS and AIS. So in the air insulated switchgear and gas insulated switchgear also, we can do the test of primary current injection to verify the design. And then other applications, somewhere for the hidden test, we need to inject for some time continuously some amount of current for some time, and accordingly we can take the results to verify the programmable interval type to check the heat trend test. Similarly, for the bus work, we can do the primary current injection test. And loose connection testing. Loose connection can easily found if there is a sparking in a connection or any joint, provided rated current flowing from it. Okay, if low current is flowing during the test, then it is likely to have a no spark. Okay, so if there is any spark, so we can directly determine there is a loose connection. So these are the major applications of the primary current injection that will be used in the high voltage or low voltage substations. Okay. Then some IEC has given some guidelines for testing of current transformers. So recommended IEC for CT testing, it is previous IEC, it was IEC 60044, but revised IEC, it is IEC 61869-1-2. This is for the CT, and for the 1 and 3, it is for FET. Okay. So this IEC has recommended to do a CT testing and interpretation of the test results we can verify. So normally, as per the IEC, CT should be tested with the limit, that is 1% to 120% of rated current. Okay, so CT should be tested from 1%, then 5%, then 20%, 100% and 120% of rated current. Also, somewhere in the manufacturing stage, for checking thermal current behavior of CT, the preferred values are 120%, 150% and 200% of rated current. So 120% to 200% of rated current, we need to inject from the CT for checking the thermal behavior of the CT core. Okay. So in IEC has specified some allowable ratio errors or accuracy limits in the IEC 61869-1 and 2. Okay. for the standard practice, we can also test cities at 20% of rated current, 40% of rated current, 60% of rated current, 80% of rated current, and also 100% of rated current. So these are the standard practices. So here, for your reference purpose, these are the some IEC guidelines that we need to follow during the testing of current transformer. So first here you can see these are the metering cores, that is the class 0.1 to 1 and below class 0.2S and 0.5S. The difference is that these are the normal cores and 0.2S, these are the special cores, special metering cores. So here accuracy class has given 0.1, 0.2, 0.51, and these are the ratio errors that during the manufacturing or during the design stage we need to follow IEC. So these are the ratio errors. These are the maximum limits of the ratio errors. Okay, for the 0.1, for at 5% of rated current, we need the ratio errors should be within below 0.4%. Okay, similarly for all the class like 0.2, 0.51, similarly for 0.2S, 0.5S. For special metering cores, we need to test CTs from 1% to 120%. And for normally metering purpose, we need to test CTs from 5% to 120%. Okay. Similarly, other class, other CT cores like protection cores like P and PR. So these are the limits, that is 5P and 5PR. Ratio error should be 1% and within 1%, and for 10P and 10PR, the ratio error should be within 3%. Similarly, for the protection course, that is, we can say PS class course, special protection course, that is PX and PXR, that is, the ratio error should be in a limit. Similarly, for transient type protection course, so these are the limits here. You can say TPX, TPY, and TPZ. 0.5% for TPX. TPY, it is 1%, and TPZ, it is 1%. Okay. So then next part is that how to select the correct primary injection test. And before, means whenever we are doing this test, what parameters I need to check for selection of the primary current injection test. Okay. So first of all, if we are doing a testing on a circuit breaker or current transformer, so just we need to understand what is our exact requirement. So first of all, we need to understand our application area. That is, where we are doing a this test, that is for on a current transformer or a CB testing or a relay testing. So then specifications point of view, how much current injection we will require. Accordingly, we need to select a primary current injection test, that is up to 500 or 1000 or 2000 or 3000 or 4000, like that. Okay, specific points we need to consider, that is the secondary current of secondary current of current transformer we need to measure or not. So this is our next part. Then timer, shall we need a timer for injection purpose or to check the trip time of the circuit breaker, like that. Similarly, weight and size of the instrument should be very less. And also we can say including test cables, the weight and size of the instrument should be less. So this criteria we need to follow. Then operation of the kit, then handling and transportation. So some arrangement like construction-wide arrangement should be there for handling purpose of the instrument. So these are the basic criteria that we need to see, and accordingly we need to select a primary current injection test kit. Okay. So if we see some customers are asking regarding the specifications of the primary current injection, that is we need an instrument that is up to range 500 ampere or up to 1000 ampere or up to 2000 ampere or 3000 ampere, which is continuous. And somewhere it is asked 5000 or 7000 intermediate range we need to give. And some point is that open circuit voltage, that is up to 3 volt or 5 volt. And the KVA rating also it is asked 5 KVA or 7 KVA or 10 KVA, like that. So, and also some customers asking for timer. So the question arises, how much is sufficient or required? Means 1000 is sufficient or not, then what we need exactly, continuous or intermittent current, then what is this, do I require this, and next question arises in our mind, what is the open circuit voltage, shall we require open circuit voltage 5 volt or 3 volt like that, shall we require a timer. So answer is that in the next slide, here you can see. So as I said, the requirement of or the selection of primary current injection test, we will refer our HV substation. If you see, I have some listed out some CTs and their ratings available in the substations. So majorly the CTs available or CTs in the substations having a ratings of like 200 by 1 ampere or 5 ampere, similarly 400 ampere, 800 ampere, 1000 ampere, 1200, 1600, and somewhere for the 220 and 400 or 765, somewhere it is 2000 ampere or 2400 ampere max. So let us consider a CT having a substation, likely a 90% having a ranges up to 16000 ampere, okay, raised to 5 or raised to 1. So as I said, as per IEC, it is recommended that CT should be tested from 1% to 120%. So below limit, it is 1%, okay? And maximum limit, it is 120%. If we see higher rating of the CT, this is a 1600. So minimum current we need to inject, it is a 16 ampere. And maximum current that we need to inject, it is a 1920. So if you refer for high voltage substation having a CT's rating 1600, 90% CT's having highest rating of CT's 1600 ampere. Okay. So the 2000 ampere instrument is sufficient for me for testing of CT's that is used in high voltage substation. So primary current that I required that is greater than 1920 as per IEC, that is 1920. So here I can easily say I can select a primary injection test kit having a rating up to 2000 ampere. Okay. If some cases like 10%, as I said, 90% of substations having a CT that is 1600 ampere, but in some cases it is a 2200 or 2000 ampere or 2400 ampere. For that cases, we can say you can go up to 3000 ampere. So these are the more and less combinations we can select. Okay. Then next part is that kit selection. For selection of kit, some major doubts, that is the what is the burden or capacity, and next one is the open circuit voltage, how much open circuit voltage should be there. So if you see the burden or capacity, the basic formula is that the primary current that we are injecting into open circuit voltage. What is the open circuit voltage? Open circuit voltage is just a potential difference required to overcome the burden of the CT, primary of the burden of the primary of the CT. So this is a voltage drop in the primary current injection cable. So as per the calculations we have provided here, how much potential difference required to overcome the burden of the CT? Here you can see. So basic formula, that is V is equal to IR, where V is the potential difference, I is the primary current that we are injecting, and R is the CT primary resistance. Normally, CT internal resistance of the primary conductor, it is very low. So R, this is the resistance very in micro ohms or up to few milli ohms. So we normally it is a micro ohm, but somewhere it is, we can say it is a few milli ohms. Okay. So generally with this calculation, we can say the generally we require around 0.8% to inject a rated current across the CT primary. So that open circuit voltage that we require, this is 0.8% max. So somewhere in that customer asking for, we need a open circuit voltage, it is a 3 volt or 5 volt, but this is not required as per these calculations. So we can say above 1 volt potential difference is more than sufficient to overcome the burden of the CT primary. So with this we can say the open circuit voltage of the instrument, it is greater than 1 volt. Okay, this is for the selection of the burden of the instrument of the primary current injection. Okay, next criteria is that If we are doing a primary current injection test on a current transformer, for that CTs having rated 1 ampere and CTs secondary rating having 1 ampere and 5 ampere. So instruments should have capability to measure the secondary side current. Okay, so this parameter that we need to consider. Then instruments should have a timer to select a range for the injection purpose. Also somewhere we are having a requirement to measure the circuit breaker trip time, or we can say stability testing. So timer should be there. Then input power supply. For selection of input power supply, single phase normally substations having, we can say single phase supply will be there. And suitable length of the power supply, that is distance between the power socket to the test object, that we need to calculate, and accordingly we will put a specifications. Then length of the output cable. The length of the output cable, whenever we are doing a test on a current transformer, the height of the current transformer from the ground level, it is roughly 5 meter or 6 meter or 7 meter, like that we need to select a output cable length. So current to be injected into the test object at erected condition, and height of the test object, that we need to calculate, and accordingly we will put a specifications. Okay, also next point is that handling and transportation. Weight of the test lead should be as less as possible, and total weight of the kit with test lead is also as less as possible. So these are total parameters that we need to consider for selection of a primary current injection test set. Okay, so next part is the ideal kit specifications. As I said, it normally maximum range up to 250 ampere, 500 ampere, 1000 ampere, 2000 ampere, and somewhere it is up to 3000 ampere is sufficient for HV testing in high voltage substation for the CT testing. Okay, so then current injection time. So for the continuous current injection time, at least for 15 minutes, or we can say at least for 10 minutes is should be there for testing purpose. Then ranges. So if here you can see generally rated current, then we can say rated current divided by 2, rated current divided by 4. That is, if you select a current set that is up to 2000 ampere, then the instrument should have different ranges. That is, if you select a 2000 ampere instrument, then instrument should have the sub ranges like 1000 ampere and also 500 ampere. So these ranges should be applicable. So with the help of these ranges, we can easily test without any disturbance or without any damage of any current transformer. If we are having an instrument, current instrument that is 2000 ampere and rated, and CT having a rated current 1000 ampere, for that we are having a selectable ranges x by 2 that we need to select. And above that, if we inject a current from the CT, that instrument should be capable to trip the circuit. So this will safety feature from the current transformer. Okay, so resolution, the minimum resolution 1 ampere should be there. So I can set easily whatever current we want with the resolution 1 ampere, and accuracy within 1%. Then secondary current, as I said, CT is normally designed, CT secondary normally designed 1 ampere and 5 amperes. So for measurement of CT currents, there should be a facility to measure 1 ampere and 5 ampere. Then resolution of secondary current measurement of CT, which should be 1 milliampere, and accuracy, which should be maximum 1%. And there should be a timer. If timer is there, then range up to 9.999 second is enough for scheme checking. If other requirement is there, you can also put there up to 99 second or 900 second or something like that. Okay, then resolution for the timer, which should be 1 millisecond. For 1 millisecond is sufficient for checking the trip time of the circuit breaker. Okay, so here overall key points that we need to consider for putting a specifications for the primary current injection test kit. Okay, the kit should be able to inject desired maximum current in the fully erected CT. Okay, the input power supply cable should be supplied during the okay, then interconnecting leads between control unit and loading unit should be supplied. Means whatever cable is there from the control unit to loading unit, there are two units normally, that is the control unit and loading unit. So sufficient interconnecting leads should be provided from the control unit to loading unit. Okay, then output current injection leads should be supplied. Then current measurement, that is secondary current measurement arrangement should be provided. Also primary current measurement arrangement is also provided. Test leads carrying case, that is separate bag, should be provided. This should be a fill arrangement that to for the easy transportation purpose only. Then individual parts parts weights and kits total weight should be mentioned in the offer. So these are the total parameters that we need to consider for selection of the primary current injection test kit. Okay, so this is overall about primary current injection test, basics of primary current injection test, and which parameter that we need to select for selection of correct or ideal primary current injection, and what are their ideal specifications. Now we will see primary current injection test sets, that is our primer series. So we are having a primer series equipment for the primary current injection test kit for testing purpose. So here you can see this is our view of primer. So basically primer is a radically new design, lightest weight in this category, modular and rugged design for the easy transportation purpose, suits equally to utilities or original equipment manufacturers, then test labs, as well as testing and commissioning companies. We are having three variants, up to 1000 ampere, up to 2000 ampere, and up to 3000 ampere. So also three variants, we have provided sub ranges for 1000 ampere. We have provided three sub ranges, that is two up to 250, 500 and 1000 max. Similarly for 200, up to 500, up to 1000 and 2000 max, and for 3000, up to 1000, up to 750, up to 1500 and 3000 ampere max. Also we have provided primary and secondary current measurement arrangement, that is primary current measurement, and separate display we have provided for measurement of primary and secondary current. Okay, so optimum VA capacity for the weight weight optimization, here you can see for 1000 ampere 1250 VA we have provided, and up to 2000 ampere 2500 VA we have provided, and up to 3000 ampere. So we have designed our instrument with the VA 3750 VA. So this instrument having a two parts, that is the control unit, that all the parameters that what we need to select, we can select with the help of control unit, and separate loading unit for boosting the current or injection purpose. So these are the two units, that is two parts, control unit and loading unit. So other functional facilities, that is separate display, as I said, then timer arrangement we have provided, automatic cutoff at 110% of the selected range. As I said, this will be a feature for testing of current transformer and circuit breakers as well. Then motorized ferrite with smooth and fine control facility we have provided. So with that, with the knob of coarse and fine control, we can easily set current with 1 ampere resolution. Then zero interlock facility with automatic ferrite zero at power on. Then safety features we have provided, like input supply fuses, then MCBs, power on indications facilities that we have provided in the instrument. Then output function in the control, output cables with higher current rating. We will see in the next slide which cables that we have used. Then flameproof primary current injection cables. Then here you can see the overall primer specifications are as follows. That is the primer one, up to 1000 ampere with some ranges 250 and 500. Similarly for primer two, with sub-ranges 1,000 and 500 and maximum current up to 2,000 ampere. And similarly for Prima 3 up to 3,000 ampere with sub-ranges 750 and 1,500. So primary current measurement arrangement we have provided and a separate display, LED display we have provided. So direct measurement of primary current through flexible CT, 5-digit LED display we have provided, ranges up to 120% of selected ranges that current we can inject and we can measure. Then range selection, as I said, resolution, best resolution, it is a 1 ampere. Similarly, for secondary current measurement and display, separate display we have provided for secondary current measurement also. For direct measurement through clamp-on CT, then 5-digit LED display and ranges up to 150% of selected range. And range selection up to 10 ampere, that is 1 ampere, 5 ampere and 10 ampere secondary CT secondary current we can measure with best resolution 1 milliampere. Cooling arrangement, naturally air cooling. Then these are the environmental, that is temperature, storage temperature and humidity. Then supply voltage, with the help of single phase supply we can operate the instrument. Dimensions, here you can see this is our main focus on that weight of our instrument is very less. Here you can see up to 1000 ampere, means 1000 ampere having a weight including all that is loading unit, controlling and test lead, it is roughly approximately 65 kg. For 2000 ampere it is 70 kg, and for 3000 ampere it is approximately 80 kg. So for weight point of view, we can say the instrument having a very less weight. And in the upcoming slide, I have made some comparisons for the weight purpose. Here you can see the front view of our front plate of our primary current injection test set. Here you can see this is our fuse that we have provided for the safety purpose. This is mains inlet that we need to connect from the main socket. So then safety MCB we have provided, then instrument on-off switch we have provided, then coarse and fine control facility separate, coarse control, and this is a fine control facility. Then output on-off control we have provided here. Then here you can see this is a timer. So with the help of timer, we can set a time for the injection purpose. Then here you can see this is a primary current measurement display. This is a secondary current measurement display. And these are the sub ranges, as I said earlier, that rated current divided by 2, rated current divided by 3. Similarly, for secondary purpose also. And these are the inputs for the primary current measurement. And this is for the secondary current measurement input. Then here you can see this part indicates this is a output connector for loading CT that directly connected to the loading transformer, and this is our earthing point. So this is overall about the front plate. So these are the accessories that we are supplying with that instrument. So these are mains in supply cable, earthing cable, then booster cable for current injection purpose, primary current cable. Here you can see these red wire shows the primary current copper cable. Then flexible CT for primary current measurement. Then flexible CT connection cable. Then other parts like secondary clamp-on CT for secondary current measurement. And this cable, secondary CT connection cable, is directly connected to secondary clamp-on for the CT secondary current measurement purpose. This is the loading transformer. Here you can see, and this is our TLS carrying case. So for your understanding purpose, how we can directly connect our instrument tool and what are the benefits of our primary current injection. As every manufacturer, if you see, there are two parts of the primary current injection test set, that is loading unit and control unit. So this is a loading unit and this is a control unit, and loading unit everyone manufacturers placing in a ground level, but we have manufactured a loading unit that we need to hang or we can place at the top or nearer to the CT tank. Here you can see this black circular indicates this is a loading CT. So we can directly hang here. So whatever copper cable length that we require from ground level to city's primary P1 and P2, that is around 8 meter or 10 meters. So what it is approximately, if we consider two or three cables for up to 2000 ampere, so roughly it is 100 ampere. So we can directly, we have reduced the weight directly around 100 kg or 120 kg for up to 2000 ampere instrument. So here you can see, so this loading CT weight is having roughly 20 kg. So with after the hanging on the loading tank, so we have reduced the weight of cable. So we have provided, we can provide a copper cable having a length 2 meter, and we can directly connect this red cable, that is copper cable, to primary points, that is P1 and P2, to the second to the current transformer. Here you can see with the help of clamp on CT, we can directly measure the CT secondary current, and which will be directly displayed on the instrument. Similarly, with the help of Rogowski coil, here you can see we can measure the CT primary current, and which will be displayed on screen. So here we are providing a booster cable having a length as per your requirement, that is 10 meter or 15 meter from the ground level to loading CT, that is we can connect. So this is overall about the connections to the DUT, that is device under test. If we connect our instrument to the circuit breaker or for the bus bar testing, so we can also test or we can put this loading CT nearer to the bus bar. Okay, that will be useful. Okay, so as I said, weight comparison, with weight comparison point of view, here you can see other OEMs, roughly you can say weight of the kit, it is 60 kg or 80 kg, and the length of the current cable, it is 10 meter they have provided, they are providing. And however, we are providing 2 meter cable, copper cable, but weight it is 8 kg. But if you consider 10 meter copper 10 meter copper cable weight, around it is 150 to 200 kg. So overall weight that we have reduced around 74%. Okay, for Prima 1, that is up to 1000 ampere. For up to 2000 ampere, we are providing an instrument having a weight 67 to 77 kg, that is roughly 75 kg approximately. But on other manufacturers' weight, including cables, test leads, then loading CT and control unit, it is around 300 kg. Similarly for 3000 ampere. So we can say that the instrument of Prima, that is, that will be easy for the transportation handling purpose during the testing also. So up to that, up to this slide, we have seen the primary current injection test set, that is Prima series. Now we are having another instrument named as Retom 30K. That instrument itself indicates the name, that is 30K indicates, that is the instrument having a rating up to 30,000 ampere. As instrument having a capability to inject a current up to 30,000 ampere. Okay. So as I said, the instrument, this instrument is capable to check the healthiness of the major applications. We can say it is CT testing, circuit breaker testing, protection scheme testing, switchgear testing, loose connection, heat run testing as well. Then, which will be used for the high voltage or substations or in a large industrial installations. Here you can see the other key applications and scope of the test. So with the help of Retom 30K, we can also test primary current injection, primary current testing of relays protection, that we can check overcurrent protection, operating current, also time and secondary current phasing, we can check. Then automatic breaker tests. In the automatic breaker test, we can check disconnector operating current time in the fault current zone, disconnector operating time in the selective fault current zone, and similarly, disconnector operating time in the overload current zone. So these are the major applications for the automatic breaker tests. Similarly, for testing of instrument transformers, easily we can check primary and secondary current, the relationship of primary and secondary current, Then polarity of primary current, polarity of CT, we can check with that instrument. Then CT load nature, we can check. Then testing of instrument, that is CT is used in energy metering. That is to define current and angular errors. And for the current and phase comparison, so with the help of that instrument, we can compare the current and phase. Okay. So these are the key applications or key applications of RATOM 30K. So this is a instrument here you can see, and this instrument having a capability to inject up to 30,000 ampere AC, and also having a capability to inject 6,000 ampere DC. So single instrument having a capability to inject 30,000 ampere AC and 6,000 ampere DC. So basically, we have this instrument divided into two parts, that is configurable for 15 kiloampere or 30 kiloampere. As per the requirement, we can supply up to 15 kiloampere type 1, and for 30 kiloampere, there is a type 2. For testing of CTs, there are additional features to check the ratios of CT, then polarity, and also additional facility. That is the demagnetization of current, demagnetization of CT. Okay. So testing of circuit breakers for DC current up to 6,000 ampere. This facility we have provided, and operating time of the circuit breaker with high current we can measure. So measurement and display parameters. So we can measure the time, then voltage, then primary and secondary current, phase angle, also secondary active reactant apparent power we can measure. Resistance, impedance, and reactance measurement facility we have provided in that instrument, and power factor cos phi that we can find out. So overall, we can say this instrument is suitable for using up to 765 or 400 kV or 220 kV in the UHV substations. So additional that external current measurement, that is up to 20 kiloampere for the secondary CT current measurement, and for external voltage measurement up to 500 volt we can measure. Also additional feature, that phase angle between injected and external currents, and between external current and voltage, the phase angle comparison we can easily get with this instrument. So other features, if you see as per features and benefits point of view, we have provided separate control unit. Here you can see this is a control unit, and these are the loading units. Optional rectifier unit, if you want to inject a DC current up to 6,000 ampere, so we have provided additional or optional rectifier unit. Here you can see this is a optional rectifier unit that is capable to inject DC current up to 6,000 ampere. So this is fully automatic instrument, that is to reduce the time for the testing. Compact, portable, and lightweight, that is 30 k in 20 kg. Means total weight of that instrument, it is this control unit and these two loading units. So total weight, it is 120 kg, we can say. Then continuously variable output current. Then high VA burden to test high impedance objects. So that is the designed VA of this instrument, that is 55 kVA maximum. Okay, digital timer we have provided to measure the circuit breaker tripping time. Then micro processor controlled technology we have used there. The self-contained, lightweight, and portable instrument is there. The instrument we can operate with the help of single phase 230 volt or two phase 400 volt. At 50 hertz frequency, we can operate this instrument. Standalone operation with inbuilt LCD display we have provided to measure the parameters and to display the parameters. Then auto cutoff tripping relay facility we have provided. Then wheel mounted trolley for easy transportation. So here you can see this is control unit. So these two loading units for AC current injection, and this is a rectifier unit for DC injection. So as per the requirement, if we are supplying, if customer wants up to 1500 kV, 1500 15,000 ampere, then we will supply one loading, one control unit and one loading unit. If customer wants up to 30,000 ampere, then we can supply one control unit and two loading units. And additional, if they want to inject DC, then additionally we can supply this rectifier unit that is having rating up to 6,000 ampere. So this is overall about the 30K rate on 30K instrument. So here you can see this chart is showing that open circuit voltage, output current, duration, and so there are some different combinations are there that we need to connect for series, parallel, series and parallel. If we take one loading unit or two loading, accordingly the connections will be there. That is 2 in series, 4 in series, 8 in series, 2 in parallel. Similarly, 2 in series, 2 in parallel, 4 in series and 2 in parallel. Accordingly, we will get a current, output current with the, we can say it is a continuous. So with the continuous, we can get up to 3,800 ampere. For 0.5 second, 8 in parallel, we can get up to 30,000 ampere. Similarly, these are the other combinations that we can select, and accordingly we can test the equipments as per the requirement. So here you can see open circuit voltage that we can achieve up to 32 volt it in 18 series. So these are the overall combinations for the output current injection purpose. So this is all about the primary current injection test kit testing and testing instrument, that is RATOM 30K and Prima series.